In this video, we'll be planning a PI Server upgrade to version 2016. Before we start upgrading, it's important to consider our current and our planned architecture and versions so we know what upgrade procedure to take. The most important consideration to make is what version of the PI Server we're currently running. I'll open my PI System Management Tools, and in Operations, I'll look at the PI version. Here I can see that the current version I'm running is 3.4, 3.80, 70, 64-bit. It's important to look this up because there's some requirements to upgrade to PI Server 2016. We have to be running version 3.4, 3.75 or later, and we have to be running a 64-bit version. Now, we can see that I'm running a version later than 3.4, 3.75, and I'm running the 64-bit version of that. Now, if you're required to make an intermediate upgrade before you make it to PI Server 2016, because either you have a version before 3.4, 3.75, or you have a 32-bit version, I'll recommend you to look at KB00530. By searching on our tech support website, you'll find this, and it'll instruct you the best way to upgrade your version into the minimum requirements to finally upgrade to PI Server 2016. The last requirement I'll talk about to upgrade to PI Server 2016 is that we need an AF server on the network. Prior to version 2010, the PI Server did not require an AF server on the network. But since 2010, there has to be an AF server on the network in order to upgrade or install a PI Server. Now, I know I don't have an AF server on the network right now, so I'm going to have to install one as part of my upgrade process. In order to better understand what the AF server is and why we need one, I'll pull up a slide. Before PI Server 2010, the PI Server stood on itself as the data archive. Since PI Server 2010, we've renamed the PI Server the data archive, because the PI Server is now going to be more than just the data archive component. The PI Server will also encompass this other piece called the AF Server. And the AF Server itself is comprised of two components, a SQL database that has to be hosted on a Microsoft SQL Server, as well as an AF service servicing that database. So now, in order to install or upgrade a PI Server past version 2010, we'll first make sure that we have to have a SQL Server on the network, and then install an AF server. And then finally, we'll be able to upgrade or install our data archive. So now that we have a better idea about the PI Server and its individual components, let's look up our live library where we can see our prerequisites for these parts. And we'll navigate to our livelibrary.osisoft.com. And here in PI Server, we'll find our PI Server 2016 guide. So I'll find the overview in PI Server installation, the installation upgrade guide, the welcome overview, and then the PI System components. Now here we can see what used to be the PI Server is now the PI data archive and the AF server together. So as you can imagine, with our PI data archive and our PI AF server making up the new PI Server definition, there can be a couple different ways that we can configure these two components. Here in the PI Server and SQL Server configuration options, we have three different examples of how you might architect your PI Server. A small PI system consisting of 10,000 or fewer assets or 25,000 or fewer PI points might look something like this, with your PI data archive, your AF server, and your SQL server all on the same machine, running SQL Server Express. For larger, more high performance PI systems with more than 10,000 assets, you might want to move your AF and SQL database off the machine with your PI data archive. And you might have your PI data archive on its own machine or even a collection of machines. And this configuration would require standard or enterprise SQL Server licenses. Finally, A distributed, highly available PI system might look something like this. And this is for load balancing and redundancy. So now that we have a better idea of how we're going to structure our PI system, I'm going to choose the small PI system for this upgrade. So I'll have my AF server, my PI data archive, and my SQL server all on the same node. Let's verify that this system that I'm going to install everything on meets our requirements. Here we'll in the upgrade a PI data archive server, in the phase 1 pre-upgrade section, we'll confirm our system requirements. Here in step 7, there's a link to system requirements, and here we'll learn that for a PI data archive 2016, the PI data archive component requires Windows Server 2008 R2 SP1 or later. So I meet that requirement, and it's important if you don't have an AF server yet that you verify that your machine meets the hardware and system sizing requirements, and you can download this PI system sizing recommendation spreadsheet to confirm that. I've already done that, so I'll move on and make sure that I have the PI AF server requirements, and I can see here that those are in the PI AF release notes 2016. So I've already downloaded those, so why don't we go to my C drive, and in my PI install folder, they're right here. And here in the operating system section, we'll see that the Windows Server 2008 R2 SP1 is a valid operating system for the AF server. And I want to use SQL Server 2012 64-bit for my AF server, and I can use the express version of that. And scrolling down a little bit further is a security requirement. So to run the AF SQL script execution feature, which is part of the AF install kit, I'll need to run the AF install kit as a user with a sysadmin connection to my SQL server. If that's not possible, or if you have a policy against running install kits as a SQL Server sysadmin, advise your SQL database administrator to follow this guide in installing or update an AF SQL database manually. So I'll meet all of those requirements. The next thing we'll do, because we're adding an AF server to our network, is make sure that the networking is going to work out. So here in a new tab, I'll navigate to techsupport.osisoft.com and I'll find a KB, KB2820OSI8. And this KB will guide us through which firewall ports we should open on our PI server. So I'll scroll down past the PI server components, because if you already have a PI server, it's very likely that those are already working. And here we're more concerned about the AF server components. So just make sure that these will be open so that your AF server is able to reach everything it needs to on the network. So once all of this is set, we'll go to our techsupport.osisoft.com website and begin downloading our install kits. So I'll now go to the Data Archive install kits and download the PI Data Archive 2016 install kit. And to download it, we'll click this button here and then follow all the instructions. I've already downloaded this kit, so I'll move to the AF server components. Back in downloads, the AF section's right here, and I'll download the PI Asset Framework AF Server 2016 install kit by clicking this button. I'll also download the SQL Server Express 2012 with tools 64-bit by clicking this button. It's important to note that if you already have a SQL Server on the network that you intend to use, you don't have to download this part of the kit. It's also important to know that if you are downloading this kit and you intend to run it, you'll install .NET Framework 4.5, and that's likely going to require a restart of your system, so make sure that you schedule this upgrade with server downtime. It's also important to download the PI Analysis Service 2016 install kit. to make sure that the AF server has all the functionality that it was designed to. The last thing we'll download on this page is down here in the white paper section. We'll download the guide on installing the SQL Server 2012 Express for PI Server white paper. And this will guide us through any questions we might have when we're actually installing the SQL Server. I've already downloaded all of my install kits, so now it's time to make sure that we can run them. So it's required that we run all of our install kits as a local administrator. So down here in my server manager, under the configuration section and local users and groups, we'll just make sure that I'm in the administrators group. And that's my GA Mercer account. So we know that I'm a local administrator on this machine. It's also important to make sure that our PI server is healthy before we attempt to upgrade it. Upgrading an unhealthy PI server could cause unexpected behavior, and it's always easier to troubleshoot one thing at a time. So the first thing we'll check is in the message logs. I'll search for the last day of messages and anything that's a warning or more severe. There seems to be only one warning about running low on resources yesterday morning, but it doesn't seem to be reoccurring. The next thing I'll look is at my current data. So in my data, current data, I'll pull in some process values of my current system. So searching for point source OPC, I'll pull in some PI points, and hitting play, I can see that all of my data is updating. So we know that there's current data reaching the PI server. Next, we'll make sure that those events are actually being archived by the PI server. In the snapshot and archive statistics, we'll hit play again. And here we'll make sure that our archived events and our events sent to queue are increasing at similar rates. We can see that in this last snapshot, I've had 29 more archived events and 29 more events sent to queue. So it's likely that any events in my event queue are also making it to my archive files. We can also see here that if I scroll down a little bit, that there's currently 0 events in my queue. So we've verified that any data making it to the PI server is also making it to the archive files. What we'll do next is we'll check our interface nodes to make sure that when our server goes down during the upgrade process, that we won't lose any data because we can buffer it. So flipping over to my interface machine, I'll open my ICU and selecting my interface, we can see that it's currently running and sending data to the PI data archive. I'm going to check the version of the buffer subsystem first. It's important to do this, so here in my programs and features, I can see that my PI buffer subsystem is running 4.5.0.17. So there should be no problems there. Now it's important to make sure that my buffer is actually working. So if I'm running PI buffer subsystem 4.3 or later, here in Tools we can click on Buffering. And in my Buffering Manager, we can see that there's no issues buffering right now. I've got ample amount of days estimated buffer capacity, so I won't run out of disk space. There's currently 0 events stuck in my buffer queue, and we can see here that I'm getting about 26 events per second being sent to my PI data archive. So that number is consistent with what I expect as my data rate. So I'll say that my buffering is working. If you're not running PI buffer subsystem 4.3 or later, you can still check the buffer queue. It'll be in a different way, so I'll show you that in my command prompt, I'll run it as administrator, and I'll navigate to my pi home directory / bin, and I'll run pybuff ss-qs. And here, after letting it refresh a couple times, we'll see that every refresh we get about 100 total event reads and 100 total event writes. This means that any data getting read by the buffer is also getting written by the buffer. So data is flowing through the buffer with no problem, and there's currently 0 events stuck in the buffer queue. Now, it's critically important to repeat this procedure on all your interface nodes to make sure that all of your interfaces will buffer when the Pi server goes down during an upgrade. Since I only have this one interface machine, I'll say that all of my interfaces are buffering and then move back to my Pi data archive. So here back on my Pi data archive or Pi server machine, it's good practice to have a fresh backup before we start upgrading. So we'll click on our operations and then backups section, and selecting our Pi server, we can see here that we're running nightly backups. So I'll run a second backup here, and I'll only include the primary archive because all the other archives were backed up last night. But I'll backup everything else to a new directory in my backups under Pi backups. And I'll add a folder called pre-upgrade backup. All right, so it looks like that is successful. So far in this video, we've planned out our expected upgrade Pi server architecture, verified that we've met all the software version requirements, and confirmed that during the upgrade process, we'll be buffering our interface data to prevent any data loss during the procedure. The next steps will be to install the SQL Server locally, and then install the AF server, and then finally we'll upgrade our Pi data archive to version 2016. The next video in the series will walk through a SQL Server installation. But if you already have a SQL Server on the network that you intend to use, you can move ahead to the upgrade to Pi Server 2016 full walkthrough video.